John Everett with Zurn Industries. Today I'd like to give you a hands-on video, and this video is going to be built upon previous videos that we did, which covered determining why your relief valve is leaking on your backflow preventer. Now, in the process of doing those videos, we pointed out that the vast majority of the time, it's a number one check that's valve that's causing the problem. Well, we had quite a few customers call up and say, hey, great, John, you told us how to diagnose the problem. Why don't you go ahead and show us how to clean that number one check? So in this particular video, what we're going to do is we're going to clean the number one check of a 3/4 inch model 975XL2. Now, again, this is a reduced pressure principle assembly. We have found through our diagnosis that the number one check of this valve is fouled, and that's what's causing the relief valve discharge. So before we get started, anytime that you're going to shut the water off to a building, always let the end user know that you are going to shut that water off. We could have processes going on inside the building that could cause tremendous problems if we just simply shut the water off. So we've gone to the end user, we found that we do have permission to go ahead and shut the water down to the building, and we're going to show you how to clean this number one check. The first thing that I want to do is I want to slowly shut off the outgoing ball valve on my backflow preventer. And again, we want to do these kind of things slowly so we don't create a water hammer condition. Once I get the outgoing shut off, I can go ahead and shut the inlet off to the backflow preventer. And then I want to take my screwdriver and open up my test cocks to bleed off the pressure. We don't want to have any pressure inside of the valve. Once we've got the test cocks open, the pressure is bled, the next step is to simply remove the number one poppet check cover. So this is the one pointing upward. Very straightforward, we loosen it up. We want to keep the palm of our hand over this cover because it is a spring-loaded cover. But once we get this cover off, inside we've got our spring and our black plastic poppet. Now, what we're going to be cleaning is the actual rubber surface of this poppet. We've had a little bit of grit or debris come in from the incoming water line. It's fouled this rubber. And when that happens, we lose our difference in pressure across this first check, and that's what causes the relief valve to go open and discharge. So again, we're going to just simply clean the rubber on our poppet. While we've got the valve apart, if it's in a location that won't cause problems, it's definitely a good idea to open up your inlet and flush the valve out. Let's flush any potential debris that could refoul that check and get it out. Once we're done fouling, we simply take the check that we've cleaned and we reinstall it back in the valve. Before I do so though, I want to make one quick point. There are times when the debris can actually pierce the skin of the rubber. And even if we wipe it off, if it's created indentations or little cuts in that rubber, we're still going to have leakage out of the relief valve. If we don't have a repair kit handy, we can take the screw and the washer off of the poppet and flip that rubber over, and that will get us a good clean side to get the valve back up and running. Now, I do want to make the point that I'm not condoning flipping over rubbers and leaving them in the valve. Basically, if you've got a bad piece of rubber, you want to obtain a repair kit and repair the valve, put new rubber in it. But many times there'll be an emergency and we cannot leave the water shut off. So as a temporary repair, we can flip that rubber over. Nevertheless, once we get our rubber cleaned up, we simply place the poppet back inside the valve, put the spring back in, and push our check cover back on and tighten it back up. At this juncture, we'll go ahead and we'll close off our test cocks, get those all closed, and we want to slowly re-energize the valve with water, very slowly. Again, if we send surges of water through, we can create water hammer that can break pipes, break the valves themselves. So we do all of this very slowly. Slowly open your inlet until the valve is pressurized. Next, we'll go ahead and crack open our downstream ball valve and slowly pressurize the downstream system. It will be evident to you when it's full because as you're filling, you will hear the rush of water moving through that ball valve, and eventually that will calm down and be quiet. At that point in time, we know we have the downstream system filled and we can continue to open our ball valve fully. It's good practice just to crack open each one of the test cocks one at a time to let all the air out of the valve. And basically at this juncture, we've cleaned the valve out, we've stopped our relief valve discharge, we've put the valve back into service, and we're ready to go. Now, if you have any questions about this, if it's not clear to you, don't hesitate to call us at Zurn Industries. We're here to support you. Give our customer care team a call. If they're unable to answer your questions, they'll certainly pass it to myself or to Daniel Alvarez, our applications engineer. Bottom line, we're here to support you and help you.